Kritam doi pae non barakata raya juhava putre titan mayatayo taravo benedus tangsava bhuta hridayam munimana tosmi anandalila maya vikrahaya himabat pyatschavi sundaraya tasmai maha premara sapradaya chaitanya chandraya namo namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Jalad Kanak Datro Nila Sonab Janitro Mrgamadavar Palo Malati Kundamalo Tarla Taruna Vesho Nila Pitambaresho Smarana Britani Kunje Radhika Krishna Chandro Shyam Sundar Shikanda Shikha Swaha Sumurali Manohara Radhika Rasikamama Kripa Nidhe Supriya Charna Kinkarim Kuru Tavai Vasmi Tavai Vasmi Najivami Tvayavana Tivikyaya Devitam Namam Charantikam First of all, I offer my sustained Dandavati Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands and thousands of times, at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev, Asmadiya Paramarat Tamaguru Pada Padma, Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnupad, Ashtotara Satashishimad, Rupa Nugacharya Varya, Shri Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Secondly, I offer my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Param Gurudev, to Srila Prabhupada and to our entire Sri Rupa Nuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. And finally, I offer my pranam to the Samut Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis in physical space and also in cyberspace. I can see you all also. Pranams to all of So today is a very, very special day. It is Varutini Ekadasi. And this day is also known as Vallabha Jayanti. It is the appearance day of Sri Vallabhacharya, the direct disciple of Gadadhara Pandit in Gaura Lila, and direct disciple of Radharani. As Radharani's parrot, Shukadeva Goswami in Krishna. So, there are several important celebrations on this day. But somehow, just by a coincidence, I was also born on this day. So, on this day, I am bound by the traditions of our Sri Guru Parampara to have a special celebration. Celebration is a most wonderful celebration. On the, of course, we worship Srila Vyasadeva on his appearance day, which is called Guru Purnima. But it is also our tradition, as observed by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Srivast Thakur also, to worship one's own individual guru on his birthday also. So the disciples worship their spiritual master, the representative of Srila Vyasadeva, not only on the birthday of Vyasadeva, but on the individual appearance day of that particular guru. From the perspective of the spiritual master, on his appearance day, it is not his duty to accept any service, any adoration, or any worship from any disciple. Never, never, and never. It is the duty of the spiritual master on his appearance day to engage all of his anugatjan, all of those who are under his guidance, in the worship of his Guru Parampara. Whole Guru Parampara. The Guru Parampara is like a garland. If you pull out any flower, then the string is broken and it's no longer a garland. So, the profound significance of the spiritual master engaging all of his anugatjan in the worship of his own guru and own parampara is to establish the correct epistemology of spiritual life. How to receive transcendental knowledge, sambit shakti. And more than that, how to experience the divine realm, the divine love, by the sambit shakti, nourished by ladini shakti, the internal pleasure potency, of which Srimati Radhika herself is the supreme embodiment. That cannot be understood by any worldly endeavor of any worldly person. So the Vedas say, Nayam atma pravachanena labhyo na medaya na bhuna sutena yameve sevrinute tena labhyas taishasatma vivrinute tanum swam. The supreme reality cannot be experienced or realized by one's own intelligence, by study of the Vedas, by giving very learned lectures, by even by so much hearing. Only the Supreme Reality reveals Himself to the person to whom He wants to reveal Himself. And that is the ultimate principle of knowledge. The Supreme Reality, the Personality of Godhead, Brajanda Nandan, Shama Sundar, Radha Vallabh, Gopijana Vallabh, Radha Raman, Radha Kanta, Sri Krishna, cannot be known in any way whatsoever by anyone. Only the person to whom he reveals himself can know him. Bas. So then the question comes, to whom does he reveal himself? And why? So the answer is this. Tomarari doi sada Govinda visram Govinda kohe namamo Vaishnava para. Srila Nartamdas Thakur says that O Vaishnava Thakur, Govinda, Sri Krishna, is always enjoying his beautiful pastimes. He's very happy and relaxed, resting in the core of your heart. And Sri Krishna himself considers. That Govinda Kahena Mama Vaishnav Pran, Om Vaishnav Thakur, you are my Pran. Krishna himself feels that he cannot live without his Vaishnav. Ama Bhakta Premi Bandhyache, Hridaya Bitare, Yaha Yaha Natabhare Dekhe Amare, Sri Krishna said, my pure Vaishnavas, they have bound me up in their heart with the rope of love, and wherever they glance, they see me everywhere. So, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakura has written, Krishna Setoma, Krishna Diteipa, Tomar Shakati Ache, Amito Kandala, Krishna Krishna Moli, Daitava Pache Pache. O Vaishnava Thakur, Krishna is yours. He belongs to you. And therefore, because Krishna is your property, you have the power to give him to someone else. So, I am simply a beggar. O Gurudev, I am simply a beggar. And I am running behind you, crying, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. This is the essence of Guru Tattva and Shishya Tattva. Kiba Viprakiva Nyasi Sutta Keninai, Yei Krishna Tattva Veta Sei Guru Hai. Whether one is the Brahmin, Vaishnava, Kshatriya, or Shudra, or Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, or Sannyas, incaste, outcaste, whatever. Only if one Ye Krishna Tattva Veta has realization of Sri Krishna, that person is Guru. And if someone wants to realize Krishna, attain Krishna, all they can do is run behind that Vaishnava Thakur crying Krishna, Krishna. To try to follow them by body, mind and words and by internal moods. To give up one's ego entirely, to become empty like a flute. Just as a flute is being empty, the musician can play very beautiful music. So when we do Shanagati, complete surrender, unconditional surrender at the lotus feet of Sri Gurudev, empty ourselves of all desires and material identification, then Gurudev can bless us with the appearance to send Krishna home. Shamsunda, go there into the heart of my desire. And Krishna, yes, of course. What else can I do for you? So, epistemology is not a complex philosophical argument. It's simply about love. Who has love has captured Krishna. And who develops love for one who has love for Krishna, receives the gift of Krishna from that person. This is Guru Tattva. On the appearance day of a spiritual master, Guru engages the disciple in the worship of Sapta Panchaka, seven groups of five personalities. First, Krishna Panchakam, because Vande Krishnam Jagat Guru. Krishna is the original Guru. So one should worship Krishna and he is the Chatur Vyuha, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Prajumna and Aniruddha. This is the first Panchakam. Then the Vyasadi Panchakam. Because it was Srila Vyasadeva who revealed to the world the Vanmayi Murti of Sri Krishna, the sound incarnation of Sri Krishna, full of rasa, in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then every spiritual master is a conduit or a channel for revealing that message of Srila Vyasadeva. So this day is also called Vyasa Puja, the worship of Vyasa.
Krishna, духовные учителя являются его последователями и проявлениями и поклоняются Патанджали в лесу.
So the second Panchakam is the worship of Srila Vyasadeva with his four prominent disciples with whom he entrusted each one to teach one of the four Vedas. So that means Paila Rishi, Jaimini Rishi, Sumantu Rishi and Vaisampaya. Then there is Vyasaki Panchakam. That is the worship of Shukadeva Goswami, the best speaker of Srimad Bhagavatam. Along with the acharyas of the four sampradayas, Madhva Acharya, Ramanuja Acharya, Vishnu Swami and Nimbaditya. Then there is Sanakadi Panchaka. The four Kumaras, they are the personal incarnations of the yoga, tapasya, knowledge, like this, the various angas of jnana, but they're also inspired to manifest bhakti. So, four Kumaras, Sanat Kumar, Sanat Sanandan, Sanatan, and Sanatan, Sanaka. These four Kumaras plus Visvaksen, who is the one eternal associate of Lord Narayan in Vaikuntha, this is the fifth Panchaka. So, this was the ancient tradition, our previous acharyas, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Srivas Thakur, all worship these personalities on this day, these five panchakams. To this, our acharyas have added two more panchakams. That is, there is Guru Panchakam as well, that means to worship your own Guru and four previous acharyas. So that is five. Now, two more have been added by our acharyas in the Gaudiya line. That is Tattva Panchakam. We worship Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sati Gaurava. And lastly, Upasya Panchakam. Who is our Upasya? The object of our worship. So that you can never forget. So the Upasya Panchakam is five personalities, Radha and Krishna, Gaura Gadadha and Gurudev. So the reason why this ceremony of worshipping all these personalities is performed on the Guru Puja is to make a very strong impression that there is a vast difference between Sampradaya and Apanta. This is an essential point to be understood. A panta means a path. It can also have a tradition and a line of gurus. But the origin of a panta is a charismatic personality who, for one reason or another, either he was born in that way, or he did austerities, but somehow or other this person has a specific perspective or realization of life. And he's very charismatic, so many persons surrender to him and hear his teachings and then continue those teachings in the tradition. So a panta is that tradition that begins with the charismatic personality.
основана какой-то харизматической личностью. Она могла родиться с какими-то особыми мистическими силами или достичь каких-то особых сил способом аскез, йоги или так далее.
Examples would include Shankaracharya.
Примеры панты. Это Шанкарачарья.
Сай Баба.
Сай Баба.
Ама. Раман Махарши.
Раман Махарши.
There are so many examples.
Очень много пант существует.
So now, Sampradaya is something else.
Sampradaya — это нечто иное.
Sampradaya does not begin with a charismatic personality.
Sampradaya не берет свое начало у харизматической личности.
At some point in history.
В какой-то момент развития истории.
Sampradaya is Sat Sampradaya, eternal.
Sampradaya существует вечно. Sat Sampradaya.
And when the universe is manifest and unmanifest, each time the universe is manifest, then Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself inspires the first living being in the universe, Brahma.
То есть когда Вселенная разрушается, снова создается, сам Верховный Господь вдохновляет сердце первого живого существа, Господа Брахмы.
О Лакшми Деви, о Махадеви, о the four Kumaras. These great personalities are directly infused with transcendental knowledge by Supreme Lord at the beginning of the universe.
Эти личности уполномочены непосредственно самим Верховным Господом прямо на заре возрождения творения.
And then the Vedas are manifest from the four mouths of Lord Brahma.
Веды являются из четырех ртов Господа Брахмы.
And so the mantras of the Vedas, along with the correct interpretation of the Vedas, are coming down side by side. From guru to disciple, guru to disciple, guru to disciple.
И после этого уже сами веды с правильными интерпретациями, комментариями не сходят по цепи ученической преемственности от гуру к ученику и так далее.
So, that it, because the supreme absolute truth can only be known, as we explained in different ways previously, when he reveals himself.
Потому что Верховного Господа можно познать только тогда, когда он являет себя сам.
Шастрайонитват. Supreme Lord is the source of the Shastra, and He can only be known from the Shastra. Srutes tu shabdamulatvat. Knowledge is based on Shastra, which is coming directly from Supreme Lord. Tasma Shastra pramanante in Bhagavad Gita. Sri Krishna says the same thing. Evam parampara bhattam imam raja shovidu. Shastra is the praman. And this knowledge, understanding of Shastra is coming from me to a person directly inspired by me at the beginning of the universe and like this until the present day.
И Кришна подтверждает Гите, что истинный Браман — это Шастра, и Шастра исходит из меня и затем передается через уполномоченных представителей.
The reason for this is the cause of all causes cannot be known retroactively by his effects. Unless he reveals himself. That which is Sarva Ashray, the basis of all existence. That which is Indriya Atit, beyond the senses and mind. That which is Sarva Atit, even beyond the devatas of the senses and beyond everything, Sarva Atit. Which is Sarvascharya, the most astonishing thing. Which is a Sarva Achincha Swabhav, which by its inherent nature is inconceivable. Cannot be known by any method of investigation. Except for a Prakrita Bhajan. That means supernatural sound. But only one who is empowered to vibrate that supernatural sound can impart that supernatural sound which gives a cognitive access to that which is Sarvascharya Achincha Swabhav, supremely astonishing and inconceivable. Therefore, knowledge only comes in the Sat Sampradaya. And it will never come in Apanta. Now, the The members of the Satsang Pradaya who can vibrate the Aprakata Shabda. They are Nirag. Nirag means they have no worldly attachments. In the Brahma Vaivarta Purana, there it is said there are two types of speakers. The Sarag Vakta and the Nirag Vakta. Those who speak, but they are attached to this world, grossly or subtly. That is a Sarag Vakta. And the Nirag Vakta, those who speak, but have no worldly attachment, gross or subtle. So there are two, and Brahma Vaivarta Purana gives two symptoms by which one can recognize the Sarag Bhakta and the Nirag Bhakta. When the Sarag Bhakta, the attached person, speaks, it does not touch the heart. It is not a ritsprasha, touching to the heart. But when the Nirag Vakta speaks, then one can feel one's heart moving very deeply. And the second symptom mentioned in the Brahma Vaivarta Purana is the Sarag Vakta, the speaker who has attachment, gives initiation and instructions to a person without examining and testing them first. An instruction or initiation given to the untested disciple is the lokanashaya, the ruination of the world. So the worship of the four Sampradaya Acharyas and Vyasadeva and his prominent disciples and all of these panchakams impresses upon us the necessity of the Satsampradaya, Sri Guru Parampara, and to be always aloof from any panta or knowledge which is not descending from the transcendental source. And remembering on the birthday of my Gurudev, we would arrange everything to do puja to him. And we would write so many glorifications of him or prepare to speak them. But once a devotee took the paraphernalia to worship him, and he stood up and pushed that devotee out of the way and took the paraphernalia out of his hand and worshipped his own guru. And then he told the devotees, he was choosing devotees one after another to speak, and everyone had prepared to glorify Gurudev, but Gurudev said, you have to speak on the subject, how to become a satsishya, a real disciple. Because when we perform puja of Gurudev, we offer flowers, but these flowers are symbolic. They're symbolic of our heart. So, the true offering to Sri Guru on Guru Puja, on Vyasa Puja, is that we ourselves try to become such a bona fide disciple. That's the real offering.
учителю, это наше чистое сердце, то есть наше преданное сердце, сердце, которому готовы служить Гуру Деву до конца и отдать себя полностью, с полной самоотдачей.
So we don't have, we have so much of a time limit today, so we can't explain fully in detail, but I've explained many times in the past, and you can hear them, and you can find these histories in Shastra. If we want to understand how to become a satsishya, then we should profoundly deliberate on the histories of the great satsishyas, which are described in the Vedas.
Того, если мы хотим научиться стать истинным садшишей, то нужно изучать досконально жизнь,
примеры истинных учеников. I'll indicate them, you should note them down.
Запишите эти имена, я сейчас их перечислю.
And know them by heart and deliberate upon them very deeply. First of all, the relationship between Upamanyu and his guru Daumya Rishi. Then the relationship between Aruni, he's the god brother of Upamanyu, and his guru Daumya Rishi also. Then Satyakama and his guru Gautama Rishi. Then Nachiketa and his guru Dhammaraj. Shabari and her guru Matanga Rishi. Parashuram and his guru Jamadagni. Janasruti
Maharaj
and his guru Raikva Muni. So these are the main examples from the Upanishads and Mahabharata and Bhagavata. Then in more recent, or we can say medieval times, Ramanujacharya and his disciples Dasarathi, Kuresh and Damodar. In more recent times, Srila Ishwara Puri, how he served his Gurudev Madhavendra Puri. And there are also examples in Shastra of how not to be a disciple. For that, you should study the case of Ekalavya and his guru, but not really guru. Because he's not really a disciple, Dronacharya and Ekalavya. And Virochan and his guru Lord Brahma. The history of Lord Brahma and Virochan is interesting. It is the history of Indra and Virochan, and one is a bona fide disciple. Indra is a bona fide disciple, and Virochan is a Asatsisya, useless disciple. And so both are illustrated in that history of Brahma, Indra and Virochan. And also at the time of Chaitanya, just before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, just as Ishwara Puri is the best example of a disciple, Satsisya, of Madhavendra Puri, so he had a god brother, Ramachandra Puri, is the example of the Asatsisya. So Ramananja Puri and Madhavendra Puri. Ramachandra Puri. So my Gurudev, and his Gurudev, and especially our Prabhupada Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, they would tell all of these histories again and again for our consideration. So
во благо своих учеников.
You can find all of them have been collected in the Upadeshavali of Upakhyan Upadesh it is called. Upakhyan Upadesh. Instructions through the deductive stories or histories. That's called Upakhyan Upadesh by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. So always on the Vyasa Puja day, on any days of Guru Tattva, and indeed every day, one must deliberate on these histories in order to assimilate the essence of the guru-disciple relationship. In Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, Tasmat gurum prapatyeta jigyasusrayam uttamam shabde paritanishtatam brahmurupashamasrayam. Therefore, because fruitive activities ultimately leads to suffering. And because a soul cannot become liberated by his own effort. Tasmad, therefore, gurum prapadyeta, one must surrender to a spiritual master. Jigyasu srayam uttamam. And in this line, the qualification of disciple is mentioned. It should be jigyasu. That means intensely inquisitive. But not intensely inquisitive about how I can be comfortable. How I can make money. How I can become respected by everyone. Jigyasu srayam uttamam. He should be intensely inquisitive how to find the Srayam Uttamam. Uttam means transcendental, eternal Sraya, ultimate benefit of my life. What is my supreme, transcendental, eternal goal which is auspicious for my soul? Disciples should have that desire, not any other. And the Guru should be Shante Parita Nishtatam Brahmanu Pashama Srayam. Three qualifications are mentioned. First, Shabde means Shabde Vede Shabde Brahmani Vede Tatparyena Nishnatam. The spiritual master should be expert in Vedic literature, in Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, Purana, Mahabharata, Ramayana, and especially in our line, the writings of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Srila Vishnu Thakur, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, should be expert, like an ocean of knowledge of all of these scriptures. And second qualification, Shabde Pare means Pare Brahmani Bhagavad Rupadi Abhibhavastu Aparakshar Bhavena. The Guru should have realization of the Swarup of the Supreme Lord. And because of that, Brahmanu Upasana Srayam, that means that Gurudev is completely detached from this world and is the abode of peacefulness. Never agitated, never disturbed, never attached to anything. Because these are all the symptoms of moha, bewilderment, of maya. One who has attained, Krishna has attained everything. They are not lacking in anything. Or hankering for something more, other than more seva. So these are the three symptoms of Sadhguru. So from the spiritual master, one receives the Dipya Gyan, transcendental knowledge. So the process is diksha.
Посредством процесса дикши.
Diksha initiation means dibhyajnanam yato dadya kurya papa sasanshaya tasmat dikshayiti sa proktais deshikais tatvako vidai. Diksha or initiation is not just a formality or a ceremony or a convention, a ritual, but rather it's a process. And it's the process by which Dibya Gyan, transcendental knowledge, is imparted to the disciple, and the Kurya Papasa Sanshaya, all the material impressions, sense, and the impressions in the chitta of the disciple are gradually cleansed away. So, Dibya Gyan, transcendental knowledge, means two things. Dibya Gyanam Yatra Srimati Mantre Bhagavat Srup Gyanatena Bhagavat Sambandha Vishesh Gyanancha. The spiritual master imparts to the disciple knowledge in the form of a mantra. And this mantra awakens that disciple's consciousness, realization of the Swarup, the divine transcendental form of his Ishtadev. And Sambandha Vishesh Gyan, the realization of one's own individual particular relationship with that Ishtadev. For example, so many people may be related to Sri Krishna. So the Swarup of there is the name, is the form of Krishna in Vrindavan. But they may be related to Krishna as friends, as parents, as beloveds, and so on. So that is called Sambandha Vishesh Gyan, the realization of your particular Sambandha Vishesh, particular relationship. So, Sri Guru gives the awakens his knowledge through Gopal Mantra. Now, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained that in this Gopal Mantra there are six swarups. Krishna swarup, Lila swarup, that means Krishna's own form. The nature of pastimes, Parikar Swarup, the nature of particular associates you will follow, Prem Swarup, the nature of the love of those associates, then Swaswarup, your own Atma Swarup, your own soul's identity, and finally Chit Prakriti means your own services to Sri Krishna in the wake of those associates. So these six swarups, swarup gyan, six types of swarup gyan, knowledge of transcendental nature, are revealed by the Gopal Mantra. But unless and until a person receives shiksha in those swarups from a shiksha guru, then the vastu prabha, the illumination of the mantra, will not manifest. Therefore, diksha is a process. Diksha can be considered in two ways, vidvat rudi diksha and avidvat rudi diksha. Avidvat rudi diksha means, the word rudi means the conventional meaning of a word. For example, pankaj means lotus. But etymologically, from the etymology of the word, panka means mud and ja means born. So actually pankaj means born from mud.
Mm-hmm.
So lots of plants grow in muddy places, not only lotus flowers. But when we say Pankaj, everyone knows we mean lotus flower, because that's the conventional usage of the word. That's called a rudi. So when persons who are in Maya use a word, they have one type of conventional meaning. But for persons who are vidvat, that means learned persons, realized persons, for them words have different meaning. So vidvat rudi diksha means diksha as it is understood by an enlightened person, not avidvat rudi diksha, initiation as it is understood by the ignorant persons in illusion. Vidvat-prati-diksha means the meaning of the word diksha as it is conventionally understood by those who are enlightened. So avidvat-prati-diksha means I've been initiated because I've got a new name. And a haircut. And smoke in my eyes from the fire sacrifice. So I'm initiated. And vidvat rudi diksha means that Gurudev has opened the door and allowed me to become a student in the college of diksha. But I'm not really diksha initiated until I graduate. So to graduate, you have to study, you have to hear and also do your homework. And be tested also. So that means, with great honor every day, the disciple should remember their diksha mantras 3 times daily. And here, about the Swarup Gyan, Krishna Swarup, Lila Swarup, Parika Swarup, Prem Swarup, and so on. And then gradually, just as the moon rises and illuminates the sky, so the 24 moons of the Kam Gayatri and the illumination of Gopa Mantra and Kam Gayatri will fill the heart and with the vision of Vrindavan, and one will have the opportunity to realize his own swarup and enter into the seva of Radha Krishna in his pastime. So, Srila Narottam Thakur, he said, Prabhu Lokanath Kave Shange Loya Jabe Si Ruper Pad Padme Mori Samarpibe. Oh, when will my Gurudev, Lokanath Das Goswami, appear in my heart in his divine form of Manjulali Manjari? And bring me and offer me at the lotus feet of Rupa Manjari. And then Rupa Manjari will bring me into a very beautiful flowering kunja, very beautiful kunja bhava. Where Radha and Krishna are seated upon a jewel throne. And I will be very shy to enter there. And I'll be hiding behind Rupa Manjari as we go inside. And Radha and Krishna will laugh and say, oh, Rupa Manjari, who's that behind you? Manjulali Dili Mora Ehi Navadasi. And Rupa Manjari will say to Radha and Krishna, oh, this is a new maidservant that was sent to me by Manjulali Manjari. That means he's Narottam Thakur's guru.
А это новая служанка для вас, которую представила Манджулари.
Sri Rupa Manjari Karachita Pada Padma Gostanda Nandana Bhujapita Mastakaya Hamoda Thakarnaka Gauri Padharavinda Sambhahanani Shanakaya Stavakim Karasini. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami has expressed similar sentiment. When Radhika is tired from dancing and singing and playing with Krishna, and she drops her head in Krishna's lap to relax, and Krishna is stroking her hair, at that time Rupa Manjari will come and massage the feet of Radhika.
Раганатха Госвами выражает подобные эмоции в своей поэзии, как когда вдовы насладились своими лилами, Радха и Кришна чувствуют усталость, и Радха кладет голову на колени.
When will I be there looking at Rupa Manjari with greedy eyes?
Рупа Манджари начнет массировать стопы Радхи, а я жадными глазами буду смотреть на Рупа Манджари.
And by a glance Rupa Manjari will indicate, come and give me the remnant. Remnant means Uchista Seva. She has not finished massaging Radhika's lotus feet, but she will give the remnant of her service to me, and she will stand up and take a chamar and fan Radha and Krishna as I massage the lotus feet of
Radhika.
So this is the path of spiritual life. First, take shelter of the Sadguru in the Satsampradaya, eternal Sampradaya. And be deaf, completely deaf to the opinions of millions of persons. If everyone on the world will climb to their rooftops and say, you're wrong, do not listen to them ever. Because we submit ourselves only to hearing from the transcendental source of Guru Parampara, Aprakrita Vachan. To go on hearing, chanting and serving very humbly. So that the process of Vidvat Vritti Diksha can unfold. And we can become situated in our eternal transcendental forms and serve Radha Krishna eternally in the company of our Guru Rupa Sakhi, Gurudev in the form of a very beautiful Gopi.
Srila Gurudeva ki jai, Gaura Premanande.